Hey DIY crafters, I'm making jewelry in the studio today, and with a few quick stitches, you can create this beautiful romantic style bracelet in no time. The first thing that you'll want to do is select your fabric, and I love using muslin fabric. And here you can see that I have a couple of different types of fabric that I would use for this project. I'll be using this beautiful imperial border dye. This is going to create a lace-like shape for our bracelet with the fabric. I'm also using this very small dye. This is called the small crown circle dye. And we're going to be using this inside of one of our bezels. So obviously you're going to place your fabric onto your cutting plate, your dies cutting side down, complete the sandwich with the base plate, and I'm going to be passing this through my Artisan Explorer machine. Now we'll need to create a base for our bracelet, and I'm going to do that out of the same fabric that I used to die cut. And you'll want to measure your wrist and then subtract an inch. So in this case, my wrist is about 6 inches. So I'm going to make the length of my base 5 inches, and I'm going to make the width about 1.5 inches. You'll want to cut out 2 pieces to that size. You'll want to cut a strip of lace that is about 2 inches longer than the imperial border that we cut out of fabric a little bit ago. And we're just going to weave this lace in and out of the holes. Now what you'll want to do is you'll want to place all of your layers of your bracelet base together and take a little running stitch all the way around the edge, just like I've done on this one here. And I've also tacked my border along the edges on each edge. I want to make the center here just a little smaller, so I've ran a little running stitch and I'm just going to gather that up. So pull that stitch and gather it and make a little stitch in the end to secure it. This small crown circle die that we cut earlier fits right down inside and matches just perfectly with this small crown bezel. So I'm just going to set that down inside, and I have my little piece of lace right in the middle. Now I have a couple of choices because each one comes with an acrylic topper. So I can use that, and I can drop in a couple of charms, or in this case I have a little heart charm and some beads. And I can put my topper on top. You'll just set this down with a little bit of glue. And of course, you can embellish around the edge with some rhinestones or any way that you like. Or as an option, you don't have to use the top. You can find some old broken bits and pieces of jewelry, which is what I think I'm going to use. And I'll just attach this into place with a little bit of glue. If you look at the finished bracelet, you can see I added rhinestone accents to the pendant, and I secured the pendant to the base with a few stitches on each side. I also added another layer of ruffled lace underneath and finished the ends by stitching buttons for a nice finished touch. I just love how lightweight and how comfortable this style of bracelet is to wear, and it's beautiful and it goes with denim. I love that. Well, please take a moment to click the like button, and please make sure you subscribe to my YouTube channel. I'm Linda Peterson. Thanks for joining me in the studio today and on my DIY channel, and keep living a creative life.